How does the world see us? Has the promotion of intrinsically American ideals such as freedom and democracy been eroded through the export of an ever more violent and vulgar mass entertainment? Issues addressed in Through a Screen Darkly, Popular Culture, Public Diplomacy, and America's Image Abroad by Martha Bayles, a professor of humanities at Boston College. And welcome to you.
Thank you.
As a starting point, there seem to be two questions. How has public diplomacy gone wrong? And how does popular culture shape our image around the world? Is that a fair overview?
That's a fair overview. Yeah. I would rephrase it slightly and say that public diplomacy sort of went away.
Went away.
Because after the end of the Cold War, we had a very robust public diplomacy beginning in World War II and going through the Cold War. And at the end of the Cold War, Americans have always been ambivalent about having the government communicate to foreign publics. So at the end of the Cold War, it was more or less decided that we didn't need it anymore because we were triumphant.
And we should say this is what you mean by public diplomacy. It's government-sponsored.
It's any effort by a government to sway opinion or cultivate goodwill among a foreign public.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, not a foreign diplomat or a foreign government, but the public of a foreign country.
So to look at where we are today, you went abroad, you talked to people about what it was that shaped their images, and you saw that what? It's mostly today it is commercial culture.
Yes, because at the same time that they cut back on the government cut back on public diplomacy, we boosted the export of our popular culture to new markets around the world because of the lifting of the Iron Curtain and the new technology of satellite television. American popular culture just poured into the world. Between 1989 and 2010, it increased about fourfold from about $3.5 billion worth a year to over $14 billion a year, and that was just the legal export. Never mind all the illegal.
And what story is it telling?
Yes, well, popular culture is a commercial undertaking, and it tends to go for the lowest common denominator. And since the media have been deregulated and with new technology, what has happened is the lowest common denominator takes the form of, you know, as we all, every American can tell you, a lot of graphic sex, a lot of explicit violence, always trying to outdo the last generation of media. But there's another kind of it that is more insidious, I think, in today's world, and that is a very dark and cynical view of American institutions and of American ideals.
You mean in our own cultural product?
In our own cultural product.
That is then seen by people abroad. To what effect? Well, I mean, what were they telling you that their image was based on this?
Well, I learned a lot of things abroad. One of the things I learned is that people feel that America has a very distinctive thing to offer the world, which is a kind of ethos, I call it an ethos, of hope for the future, but also skepticism and prudence about human nature. An understanding that human beings are ambitious and greedy. They always have been, they always will be. And people see the genius of American government and the genius of America's way of life is that we hope that people can be free, but we also understand that people will abuse that freedom. So we build in certain safeguards in our political thought, in our social organization. Most Americans will say, if they use the word freedom, they will have the word responsibility, will come right after it. We understand this in our bones. But because our popular culture is trying to attract eyeballs and audiences, it can't be bothered with that. So it accentuates a kind of libertine notion of freedom, a sort of unfettered notion of freedom, which is not very appealing to
people. But doesn't it also, popular culture, I'm thinking of music, for example, show some good things, the energy of the country, the diversity of the country? It's why it's so appealing to so many people.
Well, that has certainly been true. It was certainly true during the Cold War when we exported jazz. The government sponsored jazz tours and jazz broadcasts on the VOA. It was true at the end of the Cold War when American rock music, with no help from the government, galvanized young people in the Eastern Bloc to be more rebellious and subversive. But a lot of our pop music now is very over-sexualized, and it is not very well received in a lot of places in the world. I don't think American popular music has the same cachet that it used to have, and it's partly because we've cranked up the sexual heat so much that it turns a lot of people off.
Well, so what would you like to see?
What I would argue is that we could set something alongside our popular culture, and one of the things we could set alongside our popular culture would be our own debate over it. And engage other people in the debate over popular culture. Most countries are very don't have a critical attitude toward popular culture, toward their own or toward us. Even India doesn't really have much of a critical attitude toward Bollywood. But people, I find that in my travels, young people really like to talk about this, especially with an American. And they have all sorts of opinions about it. They love it, but they're also turned off to a lot of it. But they really would like to engage with us and talk to us. And we don't make any effort to engage with young people around the world on this topic.
But concretely, how would that engagement happen?
It could be done through our international broadcasting. It could be done through producing programs for other media channels in other countries. I don't think we really realize how we're seen around the world. We don't really think about it because to us it's a kind of exaggerated version of our own foibles and our own faults, but we automatically correct the picture and adjust the picture. But people in other countries who have no exposure to America are not as likely to do that. But we don't think about it enough. You know, I think that would help.
All right. Very interesting. The book is Through a Screen Darkly, Martha Bayles. Thank you very much.
It was a pleasure. Thank you.